Hello everyone, greetings from WeTrader, which is a community by the traders, of the traders and for the traders, where we use market profile and order flow for our trading setups. You can check this link http://whatisthemarketprofile for the most used terms in market profile. This is a small video explaining the basic features of MPLite, which is a browser-based set up for traders who want to learn and observe market profile charts. There is a wealth of information available on this platform where one can access live MP charts from any gadget and browser without any additional installation, and all of this is available by a one-step registration process which would give you immediate access to the charts. There is a pretty easy user interface once you log in, where in the top band you have the instrument name, and when you click, you get a drop down of all the scripts like Nifty, Spot, Nifty, Bank Nifty Futures, the series wise futures of Nifty and Bank Nifty. We also have the stock futures, and lastly, the options. The next tab is a time frame where you can select daily, weekly, or monthly. We also have the monthly series charting, which starts on the last Friday of a month to the last Thursday of the next month. The date consideration is for the date range you want to view the profile, and by default it shows you the last 8 profiles of the instrument which is selected. We can even see the historical MP charts, as there is data right from 27th March 2014. Next, we have the TPO size, which as per the instrument selected gives the default number for it, and which is also the recommended size to have. This TPO size can be increased for longer term charts, and the appropriate size could be selected from the drop down. For the purposes of this video, I am increasing it to 6, but the ideal TPO size for Nifty would be 2. Next, on the top bar, we have the volume profile button, which would give the total volumes of each day at every price level alongside the MP charts, and would look something like this. This is helpful to check the HVNs and LVNs, the high volume nodes and low volume nodes in the profile. This volume profile button is also available for each individual profile in case we need to watch only for the current day or a previous profile. And you can hide it back by checking the profile, checking the link and clicking on it. The last button on the top bar is a merge intralink, which merges the current day's profile, developing profile, with the previous profile. We then have a zoom slider, which you can use to zoom in and zoom out the chart space of the screen so that the data can fit your screen. Coming to the individual profile charts, we have a select button which we can use to merge two or more profiles which have overlapping or similar value, and this helps us to form a composite. In the given chart, we have the last 2 days forming almost same value area. So we can select the individual profiles and click on the button merge, and we have a beautiful Gaussian profile as a result. To reset this profile back to individual profiles, we again select this and reset. Click on the reset composite button given at the top. Below the select button, we have the volume profile, which I have already spoken about, where you can see the volume profile of each chart, and below which we have the split button, which is an equally important feature in market profile charts. Using the split profile, we can split the day's chart into individual TPOs . And for each TPO, we can see the VWAP and the POC, which are important references looking forward for the day. Coming to the main TPO charts, where we see the daily profiles being formed. We have the value area of the day shown by a gray colored box. And we have the VWAP of the day by a green band. And we show the POC of the day with a pink band. The open of the day would be denoted by a zero or an O, as seen in the chart. And we have two parallel lines, orange lines running, which is the initial balance high and low, which is the first hour high and low. This is the first hour low and this is the first hour high. The white dotted lines in the direction of the range extension gives us the 2IB and the 3IB levels. All these levels are not just visual, but it also gives you the exact level, the number, when we take our mouse over it or the using the touchpad. Be it the value, the VWAP, the POC, the IB, or the IB extension levels. And at the top of each profile chart, we have these smaller icons, which are nothing but the select profile link, the show or hide volume profile, the split profile, and the unsplit profile. So instead of using the top ones, we can even use the individual small icons to do the needful. To the right of the TPO charts and after the price, we have total volumes marked at each level for the date range. For example, this is 8 days. So this is the total volume happened at 9498 over the last 8 days. And this is selected by a color band as well as the number. The exact number of the volumes is also given. As the volumes are more, the color of the band changes. So you have the brightest color where you have the maximum volume. Along with the TPO charts, a market profiler needs to track some important information. And all this and more is provided in the table below the charts, which starts with the date, the VWAP, the value area high, the VPOC, volume POC, the value area low, the day high, IBH, IBL, the day low, open and close. Along with this, we have other information which is not seen on the TPO charts, but is equally important to track, which is the ATR, the average true range of a 5-day average and a 15-day average. We have the IB range, we have the days range, then we have the open interest, the days open interest change, the cumulative open interest of the three series, this current series and the next two, and the change in cumulative open interest. Below the cumulative open interest, we have the 15-minute volumes marked, which is very important to confirm the open type of the day and the individual volumes of each TPO below them, so that it keeps us alert in case there is a volume expansion happening during the day. The concepts of auction market theory work on all instruments and on all time frames. So it is up to us to select what time frame we want to trade in and accordingly make our plan. But irrespective of what time frame we trade in, it is important to know what is happening in the higher time frame, which is the reason we have the weekly and even the monthly profile charts, so that we can have a top to bottom approach in our trading. Here is how we can view the weekly charts. Which shows us what the option is doing on a slightly higher time frame. And obviously this week we got a trending move higher. So which is why the weekly chart is showing us a double distribution trend profile. And then we have the monthly charts, which we use to get the bigger picture. This month, when we see it as a series wise of May futures, we can see that this month is a balanced one, staying inside both the range and value of the previous month. So, and we can use this information to check if we get a move away from this 2-month balance, which could give start to a new longer term imbalance in the coming month. The last important thing to show in this video is the series wise charting, which is very helpful when a new series starts, because the players of old series would have exited and may no longer play a role in the current series. So it is important to keep a track of the new information, which can be done only by watching the latest series charts. We can also have it, as said before, we can also have a series-wise monthly profile chart, which gives us important levels on the higher time frame, which we can carry forward. This is about it for now. With this, we come to the end of this video. Thanks for your time.